Hey everybody, it's Lon Seidman here with a Plex Pro Week tip for you. Now, of course, Plex is great at sharing your personal media like TV shows and movies, but it's also very good for sharing home movies, things that you shoot on your phone that you might want to share with friends and family. And one of the nice things about Plex is that there are clients available for so many platforms. You can send video to your loved ones no matter what they've got to watch it with. And in this video, we're going to look at adding subtitles to your personal media. It's easier than you think, and it is free to do. So let's take a look and see how we can add some subtitles to a few home movies. Now, rather than having to type out these transcripts manually, we're going to use some free AI tools to do it. The best one I found so far is called Vibe. This is totally free and open source. It's available on Mac, Windows, and Linux. And what you do is you just give it a video file, and it will convert that into an SRT closed captioning file that we can use with Plex. So before we get started here, go ahead and download this, install it, and then we will give it some video and see how it does. All right, so the first file we're gonna work on is this short video clip that I took with my daughters in Nantucket last year. It's only about 15 seconds long, and I do wanna play it out so you can hear all of the dialogue in this particular video. Have a listen and a watch.
What are you doing?
I'm doing a cinematic video. So where are we, kids?
Nantucket.
Nantucket. It's a beautiful day, right?
So not much to it there, just a very short file. And of course, my kids are pretty cute, but I'm biased. And what we're going to do is drop this file into Vibe to get a transcript from it. So we're gonna switch over to my computer here. I'm using this on a Mac, but again, this will work the same on Windows and on Linux. And I'm gonna grab that file called Nantucket and just drag it into Vibe here and hit transcribe. And what it will do, to the best of its ability, using the Whisper engine, is pull out what it heard in the video. And as you can see here, we got all of the dialogue transcribed very quickly from this. I'm just gonna zoom in real quick. Now, unfortunately, in its base state here, we can't do much with this because this is not formatted in a way that Plex can recognize as a subtitle, but that is easily fixed. If we click on text here and go to SRT, it'll turn this into an SRT subtitle. But a new problem emerges here, which is that we have all of the text in one caption, and we might want to have the text change as the dialogue is said on air. So what we can do here is go over to more options, and I'm going to enable this option here, timestamps for every word, and I'm going to extend the max sentence length from its default to 55 here just to see what we get out of it. And if I rerun this now, what we will see is a much better transcript that we can work with here. So now you can see that the SRT is broken up a little bit more. Now, I did notice that it got some of the dialogue wrong when my daughter was speaking at the end about clouds in the sky. So I can actually edit that inside of the Vibe interface here, where she said, aha, and what we'll do is then fix this part to say, there's not a cloud in the sky. And now that we have it where we want it, if I click on the save button here, and I just click save, what it's going to do now is drop that SRT file inside of the folder where the video is. And I can just do one quick change to this by typing in .en.srt. And now we have a transcript that should work with Plex. And if I take that file and drop it into my media folder here on my Plex server, this will now connect up with that original Nantucket video. So let's see this now in action. All right, so now we're back on the media file here. I'm going to go over to my subtitle options, and now we should see that we have the option for an English SRT external closed caption or subtitle. So I can select that, and if I hit play now, you'll see the captioning here appearing on screen. And as that play control goes away, it'll move it from the top to the bottom. Pretty neat, right? Now, what we're noticing though, or what I'm noticing at least, is that the text is a little bit hard to read here on screen. So maybe I want to adjust how that looks. So if I go over to my settings here under playback settings, and we go over to the subtitle styling section, what I can do is add a background to the mix here. And that way it'll look more like a typical closed captioning might. So if we back out here now and maybe just rewind a little bit, we'll see now that our caption has a background behind it, which makes it a little bit easier to read here. So let's wait for that control to disappear, and there you go. So now you've got a caption with your personal media that you could put together completely with free tools very, very quickly. But we're not done yet. Maybe we want to put it into a different language. Let's take a look at that. So I went over to ChatGPT and I gave it the SRT file that we just created, and I asked it to translate it into German, which it appears to have done. And then grabbed the text and I opened up a text editor where I pasted that text in. And now I am ready to save the file. And what I'm going to call this one is nantucket.de.srt. And the DE here is the designation for German, like the EN on my other file was a designation for English. And then I'm going to click save here. And now we have two SRT files on our Plex server. So now let's go back to the media and see if we have the option now to get the German subtitles loaded up. All right, so here we are once again on the media file. And like before, I'm going to go over to my subtitle option and look at that. Now we have German. And if I go ahead and play it here, as you can see, we are now getting German subtitles. So if you have family in other parts of the world, you can translate everything there for them so they can keep up with everything that's happening with your family on this side of the Atlantic Ocean. Now, if you're looking for more information about subtitles, you can head over to the Plex support pages and get all the information you need there. And there you will also see a link to the abbreviations for different languages. And so if we click on the two-letter option here, that will take us over to Wikipedia, where you can see every language that Plex supports and the two-letter designation that you'll need to name your file to in order for it to be recognized. So there you go, captioning your personal media files on Plex. And what's neat about Vibe here is that it also works with music. You can see that it was able to successfully transcribe the lyrics to this song that my kids made up. I didn't have to do anything. It picked it all up and even put a little music emoji in there as well. So pretty cool stuff. And if you are looking to add some subtitles to your personal media, hopefully this helped make that process more efficient for you. This is Lon Seidman on behalf of Plex, and thank you for watching.